Because let's face it, you could be waking up next door.
If Danny had been here, you know, it could have been a different story. He'd be doing dance moves.
I've been telling
that's a shame, isn't it? It's a bloody shame.
I've been telling him I've spent at least 3 years of my life waiting for that.
Yeah.
Oh, he was always late in the early days, always late.
He never improved, no.
No, I know.
He never improved.
We expected him to be late.
He never improved.
We expected him to be late, he would be late.
Yeah.
And nothing happened.
Because if I'm late, which has happened to all of us, something goes wrong and you're late, and I go in all guilt-ridden, white, middle-class, tossy, honky, twat, and I apologise, I'm so sorry, I'm late. Danny's like an hour and a half late.
Hey, we're here, isn't it?
Like a shred of guilt, not that scintilla of discomfort. It's true.
If you asked him why he was late, he'd just go on and he'd just say, forget it. And he'd be late again.
There was a great moment when we recorded the last series when he came in his Chinese built scooter, which he was very proud of. It was amazing, nice thing, isn't it? And he showed Chris it. Chris wasn't that impressed. Oh, Dan, how much is the fuel gauge working?
It's fine, shake it.
You know, it's absolutely on empty. I don't know a lot about engineering, but you know, that needle should be on E. He's sort of halfway up or near F. So he goes, goes off, and then I'm driving back 10 minutes later, and then I see in the headlights in the drizzle, in the grey drizzle of West London, a little scooter on the side of the motorway, and Danny on the phone. So I pull up and stop, and that's where my life turned into absolute chaotic hell for the next 24 hours, trying to sort out Dan's scooter. He left it there and someone nicked it. But then he got it back, the police rang and you were on stage. The police rang down and said, yeah, we found your scooter. And he was like, oh, God. And some kids had managed to start it and drive it like half a mile and then got contact.
Good thing about him, though, is he's got me one of them for free. And I pick it up in March.
Oh, you get one towards there,
you don't drive, do you?
What?
Do you drive?
Well, I do. Well, I have to.
You never did drive.
Yeah, I've got a driver.
You always had a driver.
We drove me around South London once in a Rolls Royce. Remember that?
I used to have a Rolls Royce.
Is that the only picture you could get of?